Hi all, a great morning to all. This is VC here from VC's Academy. In today's class, we will discuss about biological classification, which is of Chapter 2, Unit 1, Diversity in the Living World. So what we will discuss today? We will discuss about classification of organisms and the systems which are involved in it. Coming to the first classification, who was done or who gave classification for the first time? Earliest classification was given by Aristotle. He divided plants and animals. He divided plants into herbs, shrubs and trees, and animals into those with RBCs and those who do not have it. That means which are having red blood cells and which are not having red blood cells. Based on them, he categorized animals into two groups. And the two kingdom classification was given by Carolus Linnaeus. He divided plant kingdom and animal kingdom. He gave two classification of kingdom, that is plants and animals. And coming to the very authentic one, which is five kingdom classification given by R.H. Whittaker. He categorized organisms into Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae and Animalia. These are the five kingdoms which were given by R.H. Whittaker. Before going into the next slide, what are the key points here? Earliest classification was given by Aristotle. He divided plants into herbs, shrubs and trees, and animals into those which are having RBC and those which are not having or not possessing them. Two kingdom classification. The two kingdom classification was given by Carolus Linnaeus. He divided organisms into plants and animals. And coming to the five kingdom classification, it was given by R.H. Whittaker, and he categorized organisms into five. They are Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae and Animalia. Coming to Kingdom Monera, what all are included in Kingdom Monera? They are Archaebacteria, Eubacteria, Mycoplasma, Actinomycetes. All these are included in Kingdom Monera. So what are the five kingdoms? We have Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae and Animalia. Coming to the first one, it is Kingdom Monera. What are all included in Kingdom Monera? Archaebacteria, Eubacteria, Mycoplasma and Actinomycetes. These are all are included in Kingdom Monera. Coming to one by one, Archaebacteria. These are called as special Monerans as they live in mostly harsh habitats. Very harsh habitats are easily adapted by these Archaebacteria. For example, halophiles, which called as halophiles, those which live in extreme salt conditions are called as halophiles, and thermohydrophiles, that which live in hot springs, very hot water springs, these are called as thermohydrophiles, and methanogens, which live in marshy areas. So we have three types of examples for Archaebacteria. They are halophiles, thermohydrophiles and methanogens. Halophiles, which live in extreme salt conditions, thermohydrophiles, which live in extreme hot springs, methanogens, which live in marshy areas. And coming to the one more important point of Archaebacteria is that they differ from other bacteria in having a different cell structure. They have a different cell structure which differentiate them from other bacteria. The cell wall does not contain peptidoglycan but contains pseudomurine. Generally, the bacteria contains peptidoglycan cell wall, but the Archaebacteria possess pseudomurine. And coming to Eubacteria, this type of bacteria or this category of bacteria are the most abundant microorganisms. They occur almost everywhere. So wherever we have, if you take a handful of soil also, you can find hundreds of bacteria of Eubacteria. They live in extreme habitats like hot springs, deserts, snow and deep oceans. Many live in or on other organisms either as parasites or symbionts. We can find Eubacteria as parasites or symbionts which live on other organisms or in other organisms. They can be habitated in hot springs, deserts, snow and deep oceans. And we can find them everywhere, almost everywhere we can find eubacteria. There are hundreds of bacteria found in handful of soils. This is about eubacteria. And coming to categorization of bacteria based on their shape, bacteria are categorized into four shapes or four categories. They are the spherical bacteria, which is called as coccus bacteria, the rod-shaped bacteria, which is called as bacillus bacteria, and the comma-shaped one is called as vibrium. The spiral-shaped is called as spirillum. The bacteria are characterized by the presence of rigid cell wall containing or consisting of peptidoglycan, which is also called murine or mucopeptide. So as I have earlier said, that bacteria is characterized by the presence of cell wall which is containing or consisting peptidoglycan, which is also called murine or mucopeptide, whereas archaebacteria pseudomurine is present. The infoldings of cell membrane are called as mesosomes. So what are the infoldings of cell membrane in bacteria called mesosomes? Coming to the next one, genetic material is basically naked, that is, it is not enveloped by nuclear membrane as in all prokaryotes. And if we see the cell organelles, except ribosomes, other cell organelles and prokaryotic cells are not found in bacteria. And coming to the cell organelles, what are present in bacteria? Ribosomes are present, and bacteria which are motile contains either one or more flagella. Bacterial structure is simple but very complex in behavior. If we come to the point, the structure of bacteria is very simple but its behavior is very complex. Compared to other organisms, bacteria as a group show most extensive metabolic diversity. When we compare bacteria with other organisms, bacteria as a group, they show most extensive metabolic diversity. And some bacteria are autotrophs, which can be photosynthetic bacteria or chemosynthetic bacteria. So coming to the points which we have discussed, the genetic material is naked and they don't have the envelope of nuclear membrane as we observe in prokaryotes. And coming to the cell organelles, ribosomes are present and no other prokaryotic cells or cell organelles are found in bacteria. The bacteria which are motile moves with the help of flagella. They have one or more flagella with which they move. And coming to the structure, it is very simple but very complex in behavior. When we compare other organisms to bacteria, bacteria as a group, they show most extensive metabolic diversity. Some bacteria are autotrophic, such as photosynthetic or chemosynthetic. Vast majority of bacteria are heterotrophs. We know what is meant by heterotrophs, right? And coming to cyanobacteria, the cyanobacteria, which is also referred as blue-green algae, have chlorophyll A similar to green plants and are photosynthetic autotrophs. So the cyanobacteria, which we also refer as a blue-green algae, have chlorophyll A. The component chlorophyll A is present in cyanobacteria, which is very similar to green plants, and hence they are called as photosynthetic autotrophs. Cyanobacteria are unicellular. They are single-celled. They live as colonial or filamentous, either aquatic or terrestrial algae. So we can find them in colonies or in filamentous or aquatic or terrestrial habitats are observed. And they are unicellular. They are the most primitive organism showing oxygenic photosynthesis. When we talk about the primitive organisms which show oxygenic photosynthesis, we refer cyanobacteria. The protoplasm of cyanobacterial cell is differentiated into a central colorless centroplasm with chromatin material and peripheral pigmented chromoplasm. So the protoplasm of the cyanobacterial cell is differentiated into a central colorless centroplasm with chromatin material and peripheral is pigmented chromoplasm. And the colonies and trichomes or filaments are generally surrounded by gelatinous sheaths. They often form blooms in polluted water bodies. So the cyanobacteria, which are generally observed as blooms in polluted water bodies, some of these bacteria fix atmospheric nitrogen in specialized cells called heterocysts, for example, nostoc and anabina. So these help in fixing atmospheric nitrogen also with the help of specialized cells called heterocysts. They form hermogonia or fragments or thick-walled achenids during asexual reproduction. And at the time of asexual reproduction, they form hermogonia or fragments, and the flagella are absent in vegetative or reproductive phases. Coming to the red color of the Red Sea is due to the trichodesmium erythrium present in it. Coming to the chemosynthetic autotrophic bacteria. The chemosynthetic autotrophic bacteria oxidizes various inorganic substances such as nitrates, nitrites, and use the energy released for ATP production. They play a major role in recycling nutrients like nitrogen, phosphorus, iron, and sulfur. And due to the presence of trichodesmium erythrium, the red color is observed in Red Sea. Majority of heterotrophic bacteria are saprophytes or decomposers. When we see heterotrophic bacteria, majority of them are saprophytes or decomposers. There are useful bacteria also. They are helpful in making curd from milk, production of antibiotics, fixing nitrogen in legume roots, etc. We have helpful bacteria or useful bacteria which helps in making curd from milk, production of antibiotics from fungi or something else, or the matter, fixing nitrogen in legume roots, etc. And some are pathogenic, which cause damage to human beings, crops, farm animals, and pets. So we have harmful bacteria which cause damage to human beings, crops, farms, farm animals, and pets. Some of the examples of diseases which are caused by bacteria are cholera, typhoid, tetanus, and citrus canker. Coming to the reproduction of bacteria, they reproduce mainly by fission. Sometimes under unfavorable condition, they produce spores which are called as endospores. They also reproduce by sort of sexual reproduction by adopting a primitive type of DNA transfer from one bacterium to another. They reproduce by a sort of sexual reproduction, which is a very primitive type of DNA transfer from one bacterium to the another bacterium. Coming to mycoplasma, these organisms completely lack cell wall and are pleomorphic. The mycoplasma are lacking cell wall completely, and these are pleomorphic, which means they can be seen in many forms. They are the smallest living cells known and can survive without oxygen. Many mycoplasma are pathogenic in animals and plants. These mycoplasmas were earlier called as PPLOs. The abbreviation of PPLO is pleuropneumonia-like organisms. These mycoplasmas cause witch's broom in plants, pleuropneumonia in cattle, and mycoplasmal erythritis in humans. Coming to mycoplasma, this category of bacteria are completely lacking cell wall, and these are pleomorphic. That means they are available or observed in many forms. And these are the smallest living cells which are known, and these can survive without oxygen. So these are able to survive without oxygen. Many mycoplasmas are pathogenic in nature, both in plants and animals. Coming to the mycoplasma's earlier name, or the first name which was given to mycoplasma, was PPLO, pleuropneumonia-like organisms. Later on, it was given as mycoplasmas. And these mycoplasmas causes witches' brooms in plants, pleuropneumonia in cattle, and mycoplasmal urethritis in humans. This is about mycoplasma. Coming to actinomycetes. Actinomycetes are branched filamentous bacteria which form radiating colonies in culture. So these are branched filamentous bacteria which forms radiating colonies in culture. Cell wall contains mycolic acid. The cell wall of actinomycetes contains mycolic acid. Most of the actinomycetes are saprophytes and decomposers. Mycobacterium and cornibacterium are parasites. A number of antibiotics are produced by actinomycetes bacteria members, especially like having the genus Streptomyces. Actinomycetes, what are the key points of actinomycetes? These are branched filamentous bacteria which form radiating colonies in culture. When they are cultured, they give radiating colonies, and the cell wall contains mycolic acid. These, most of them are saprophytes and decomposers. Examples for actinomycetes which are parasites are Mycobacterium and Cornibacterium. An number of antibodies are produced by actinomycetes bacteria, especially the members of the genus Streptomyces gives a large number of antibodies. That's all about Kingdom Monera. In my next class, we will discuss about Protista. Thank you.